Hello, welcome to Unknown India channel. In this video, I will take you to the Korigarh Fort. Korigarh Fort is located at 24 kilometers from Lonavala. To avoid traffic in Lonavala, I choose Pune Kamshet Pavnanagar Korigarh Road. I am heading towards Kamshet via Pune Mumbai Old Highway. We are at Kamshet village right now. Take left from here. This road will take us to the Pavnanagar village. This is ancient Kedarnath temple. We are at Pavnanagar village right now. After Pavnanagar village, take left to the Javan road. On this road, Tikona Fort is located. Here you can see the Pavna river. On right, you can see the backwater of Pavna Dam. On left, you can see the Tikona Fort. We are at Javan village right now. Take right from here to Javan Tungi Road. This road will take us to the Lonavala Ambi Valley Road. Some of the road patch is in very bad condition. Be careful on bridges like this. It has no railings. In front you can see the Tunga Fort. The road is narrow, you have to be very careful. Many cyclists visit this area in monsoon. On right there is boating facility available at Pauna Backwater. We are at Gusalkham village right now. Take a right and after that take immediate left to MB Valley Road. Road to MB Valley is really in good condition. This road is full of beautiful landscape. You can see the Korigad right there. We are near Pet Shahpur village. You can see Korigad on left. In front you can see parking where you can park your car. We decided to park our bike at Pet Shahpur village. Near the temple in Pet Shahpur village, there is ample space available for parking. I park my bike right here. Behind the temple, there is way to the Korigad fort. From Pet Shahpur village, it took 30 minutes to reach base of Korigad fort. In 1657, the Maratha Emperor Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj conquered Korigad Fort along with the forts of Lohgarh, Visapur, Tunga and Tikona. There is little rain. On 11th March 1818, British Colonel Prothero tried to take over this but even after a prolonged siege, could not make any headway. Finally, on 14th March, by igniting the store ammunition by means of a loose cannonball, he succeeded and this fort went to the British. We are now going to enter in jungle near the base of Khorigarh Fort. Be very careful in this part of trek. Here there are many snakes around. I found one on top of Khorigarh Fort. We are near base of Khorigarh Fort right now. These are the historic stairs of Khorigarh Fort. There is the main entrance of fort. The height of Khorigarh Fort from sea level is 923 meters. When you cover half of the distance, there is a cave and a Ganesh temple. There are many wild monkeys around, so you have to be very careful with your loose handbags. These monkeys will try to snatch your food. Please avoid eating anything in front of them. This is Lord Ganesh idol at the temple. These stairs will take us to the gate of Khorigarh Fort. These stairs are recently renovated using concrete. It becomes slippery due to flowing water. Be careful while climbing. On the way, a small cave is there. In this cave, the drinking water is available. We are heading towards main entrance of Khorigarh Fort. This is the main entrance of Khorigarh Fort. We just entered through main entrance. On right, you can see the historic remains of old building. Near the entrance, there are two caves. We are on plateau of Khorigarh Fort. You can see the fortification here. From here, you can see the magnificent view of Amby Valley. Let us go towards that bastion. From the top of bastion, you can see the magnificent view of Amby Valley. We will walk around the perimeter of Khorigarh Fort. By this way, you can view each and every structure on Khorigarh Fort. The total perimeter of Khorigarh Fort is around 2 kilometers. You can see an old cannon lying around the fortification. There are total 6 cannons on the fort. We are moving towards bastion on extreme south end of Khorigarh Fort. From the bastion, you can view the Amby Valley. Also, there is primary fortification. You can view the runway of Amby Valley. This runway belongs to the Amby Valley. There are two more cannons on the way. lying around for defecation. Here you can see remains of second gate of Korigarh Fort. There are many crabs around. Do not try to tease them. They can harm you. We are at Goddess Koroi Temple. The pole-like structure is actually a tower of lamp. This temple is recently renovated. Let us move forward. This cannon is known as Lakshmi Cannon. It is the largest cannon on Korigarh Fort. There are three temples on the fort. This one is Goddess Koroi Temple. This one is Lord Shiva Temple. There are two large water reservoirs. This one is Lord Ganesh Temple. The stones used for construction of Korigarh Fort was excavated from this place. After excavation, this place is used as water reservoir. Here there is a small dam. Let's go to the north end of Korigarh Fort. This is bastion at north end of Korigarh. From bastion, you can view the parking. This is road to the Pet Shahpur village. Near this temple, I park my bike. By this road, we came to the Korigarh Fort. Let us move forward. Can you see something? This egg is just lying on the stone and we are not able to recognize it. A snake is a cold-blooded creature. To start their daily activities, they have to warm their body in sunlight. So be careful when you are at places like this. If any of you know the name of this snake, please mention in comments. Let this buddy enjoy his sunbath. We will move forward. We walk around the fortification of Korigarh Fort. And now we are going back. The perimeter of Korigarh Fort is 2 kilometers and it took 40 minutes to finish it. I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can follow Unknown India channel on Facebook or Twitter. Hit the red button to subscribe. Thanks again.